Hi everyone, it's Gus from Pie My Life Up. Today I'll be going through the steps to setting up ownCloud on the Raspberry Pi. ownCloud is an open source file syncing, sharing and collaboration software. It is similar to file storage solutions such as Google Drive, Dropbox or OneDrive. However, with ownCloud you'll need to integrate advanced document editing tools. It is a great option if you're looking for a way to set up your own private cloud storage. For allowing external access, I recommend using something like Cloudflare Tunnels or TailScale. Alternatively, you can port forward or use a self-hosted proxy like Traffic or Nginx Proxy Manager. For this tutorial, I will be using a Raspberry Pi 5 running Raspberry Pi OS Bookworm. To begin, SSH to the Raspberry Pi or open the terminal on it. First, update the package list by entering sudo apt-update. Now upgrade any out-of-date packages by entering sudo apt-upgrade-y. For this tutorial, we will be using Docker, so you'll need to make sure you already have Docker installed. Docker --version. If Docker is available, you'll see the version that is currently installed. If you don't, I have linked a tutorial on how to install Docker in the description below. Now we need to create a directory for where we will store our Docker Compose files. To do this, enter sudo mkdir -opt/stacks/owncloud. The -p ensures that all directories will be created if they are missing. Now change into the directory by entering cd /opt/stacks/owncloud. Before we proceed further, we need to make sure we have wget installed. Enter sudo apt install wget. In my case, it is already installed. One last thing we need to do before we start writing the Compose files is to get the IP address of the Raspberry Pi. You can get the IP address by entering hostname --i. The IP address is the first one in the list. Now it's time to write our Docker Compose file. Since it is such a large file, we'll be grabbing the template from our Git. To do this, enter the following command. sudo wget https://git.pymylifeup.com/compose/owncloud-pi/compose.yaml. Once downloaded, you can open it to view the contents. Simply enter sudo nano compose.yaml. In here, you can see all our services that we plan on installing. Any part that starts with a dollar sign, then curly brackets, is a placeholder for an environment variable, which we will be doing in a minute. If you know what you are doing, you can change any of these settings to fit your needs. By using this Compose file, Docker will install ownCloud, MariaDB, and Redis. ownCloud relies on MariaDB and Redis being online. If either of these are offline, it will fail to launch. Once you're done viewing the file, simply press Ctrl+X to exit. Now it's time to sort out our environment variables. To get our template, enter the following command. sudo wget https://git.pymylifeup.com/compose/owncloud-pi/.env. Now enter sudo nano.env. In here, you can see all the environment variables that we will need to set. The version placeholder represents the version of ownCloud you want to run on your Raspberry Pi. I recommend using latest. Swap domain or IP with the address you wish to access the ownCloud instance. For example, I will use my Raspberry Pi's IP 192.168.0.15. Swap HTTP port with the port that you wish ownCloud to listen on. I recommend using a port such as 8080 or similar to avoid conflicts with other software. For ownCloud trusted domains, enter the IP address we entered earlier. If you want to use multiple domains or IPs, separate them with a comma. Replace admin username with the username you wish to use for your admin account. In my case, I will simply use Pi My Life Up. Replace admin password with the password you wish to use for your admin account. Again, I will use Pi My Life Up. It's important to note that the admin username and password are only used for first setup. If you want to change this later, you'll need to do it within the web interface. Replace HTTP port with the same port we specified earlier. In my case, it is 8080. Now, mount path is the path for storing the data of ownCloud. For example, using /data will store it within the opt/stacks ownCloud directory. You can change this directory to whatever best suits your needs. Once you're happy with all the environment variables, simply exit and save by pressing Ctrl X at the same time, then Y, and then Enter. Now it's time to start the ownCloud server. To do this, simply run docker compose up -d. The -d will have Docker run in the background. It may take a few minutes to download all the required software. Once done, open your favorite web browser and go to the IP address followed by the port number. In my case, it is 192.168.0.15:8080. You will be greeted with a login screen. Simply enter the admin username and password you set in the environment file. In my case, it is PyMyLifeUp and PyMyLifeUp. You'll now see a screen with all the apps that you can connect to your ownCloud server. For now, we will simply click the X in the top right hand corner. You can view all the settings that you can change by clicking on the menu in the top right corner and then selecting Settings. Feel free to browse these and change anything that you need. To test that file uploading is working correctly, simply drag a file into the web interface. As you can see, mine is uploading files correctly. Updating ownCloud is the same process that you use to update any Docker stack. Simply go to the terminal and change the directory to where our compose file sits. For example, cd /opt/stacks/ownCloud. In here, simply ask Docker to pull the latest versions by entering docker compose pull. Lastly, have your Docker move you to the new versions by entering docker compose up -d. Now, backing up ownCloud is a relatively straightforward process. First, make a backups folder by running the following command: sudo mkdir -p /backups/ownCloud. Now change to the directory of where our compose file sits: cd /opt/stacks/ownCloud. Now use the ls command to verify we are in the right place. We will need to back up the data and MySQL directories. Now stop our container by entering docker compose stop. Now I recommend using something like rclone to back up all the Docker files to a remote location. However, as an example, I will simply be using the cp command. Now enter sudo cp -r /opt/stacks/ownCloud/data /backup/ownCloud. The -r makes the copy command recursive. Now back up the database by entering sudo cp -r /opt/stacks/ownCloud/mysql /backup/ownCloud. Verify the files have copied correctly by entering ls /backup/ownCloud. And as you can see, the directories have been copied correctly. This is a very basic example. I recommend using automation, versioning, and a remote storage to improve the reliability of your backups. Lastly, bring the Docker back online by running docker compose up -d. I hope you now have a good understanding of how to set up ownCloud on the Raspberry Pi. If you have enjoyed this tutorial, please be sure to like the video and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.